name is Beth Hiley here for Board Game Geek TV at Spiel 2014. I'm sitting down with Marco Pranzo of Jockix.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm fine. A little bit stressed, but it's okay.
Everyone, I'm sure, will notice also a designer name on the box. So this is your game, which is Historia.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And so just give us an idea, what is this game about?
Okay. This, as the name suggests, it's a civilization game. The idea is to have a quick as it's possible for the game with this team, that is not easy at all to manage to make a short game and to put everything that one expects from Civilization's game into 1 hour, let's say 25 half an hour for players. That's it. So that's the main idea of the game.
Okay, so if we were playing this, how many players?
It goes from 1 to up to 6 players, and it scales quite well. The game scales from 1 up to 6 players, and especially when playing with few players, there are some what we call the civ bots. It's basically the other civilization that played with the cards, that act with cards, and so the game, it works.
Now, I'm guessing by the score tracker on the edge of the board here that our goal is to get points or victory points.
Yeah, exactly. Obviously, as this kind of game, we measure victory points. It's not clear what they are actually, but okay.
A measurement of something.
Yeah, exactly. And how you I think according to the rules, it's something like how you influence and you make the history of the world, okay, and so on and so forth. So that's it. But basically, for gamers, players, it's just victory points. That should be enough.
All right. So what would a turn look like if we went to play?
Yeah, a turn. It's basically it's the main. The main mechanism of the game is that each player has a set of 10 action cards, and every player simultaneously they will select some card, and then the cards are turned off and the actions will be performed.
And then we're all revealing that simultaneously?
Yeah, exactly. So, and the action then they are resolved according to the turn order, and that's usual. So let's see, for instance, some actions. First of all, let's see what's on the game board, because it needs to be explained. Okay, we have the main part is this, which we call the development matrix. Here, a marker on the matrix represents how my civilization is developed from a technology point of view. Mm-hmm. So we have here all the technologies, and from military point of view. So this is a kind of balanced situation, but you can also have something like here, which you have a lot of technology but low military, or on the other way around, something barbarians, where you have a lot of military levels and a few less technology levels. So that's the position, that's the main part of the board. Here we have each icons of this one. It's a technology. For this one, it's gunpowder, scientific method, industrial revolution, so on.
Sort of a major technological advance.
Yeah, the major advances. And actually, it was quite funny just to review history and trying to find out which were the 17 major elements in the game, and possibly to make them well spaced over the time. Not to have all of ancient time too modern. Actually, it's fun is this one, it's the singularity, which is something like when computer will be more intelligent than humans, so it's something that is near future, maybe. we don't know, it's some funny, some inside joke in the game, and there are several of them.
And to take a guess, I'm guessing that these color blocks here are sort of represent a grouping of, yes.
Yeah, that's exactly, it's the government. For instance, here in this area here is the empire, here it's the city-state. So, for instance, it's the yellow marker, it's here, means that the civilization of the yellow player is in a city-state, and at the end of the turn, each civilization will score some point according to its position. So if you are in enlightenment, something like here, there will be 5 victory points.
Okay.
So that's the main part, and then we have the map. Of course, the game is also played on the map. We have the territory, so if I have my cube here, it means that my civilization, in some sense, influenced this area of this region of the world. And as I expand on the map, then I will put my cubes, my power, what we call power cubes here on the map. And the power cubes is something I think quite original and interesting, because at the beginning of the game, each player starts with a few of them. And you will use them both for developing, for instance, new technologies, mm-hmm. and both for expanding on the map. So if your civilization is very widespread, then you will have less cube to spend for doing actions. So it's kind of negative feedback, and it will balance the mechanism. On the other hand, you will, if you have only one territory, you will have more cube to spend for doing actions.
But less points from controlling areas
of course, less points from the map. But more chance for doing. Probably the best is to have some balanced situations. And then lastly, we have this, which is the timeline. And the game lasts 1, 2, 3 eras. And for each era, we have 4 turns.
Seasons?
Yeah, 4 seasons, 4 turns. And these symbols, these all the small symbols here, they are all the operations that happen at the end of the turn. That's it. And the length of the turn is variable. Depends on how the games evolve, how the players play. I'm explaining it. So for instance, let's take this action. This one is the technology action. So if I play this action, I will, and let's say I'm the red player, I will advance by 1 level, probably. Okay, it's written here. Okay. I will pay. Oh, I'm playing with the red now. So I'm going to pay 1 cube. The cube that I have in front of me, they are the reserve. They are the available reserve. So they are the cube that I can spend on doing actions.
Okay.
So I can spend 1 cube, and I will put in the use of the pool. This one, they will stay here until I find a way for taking back and then to spend them again. And these are the same cubes that I also put on the map. And each action has usually they have two levels. I mean, two versions. Because I have the basic version, which I spend 1 cube and I gain 1 level, and the advanced version, which I spend 3 cubes and I gain 2 levels. The catch is that this advanced version will be available as the players play.
Oh, so I'm guessing
so at the beginning of the game,
have to cross that threshold since those pictures.
Yeah,
match.
This one is the scientific medals, and so after you have that, you can start develop technology quicker.
Right, which makes sense historically as well.
And all this technology and all the effect, as far as I tried a lot. I tried a lot to make them making sense as far as possible. So for instance, gunpowder will help you in making rides and so on. The navigation will help for trading and so on. So the main actions are the development on the technology, and the other one is the development, on the military. And they are the dual, they are
complementary,
exactly. And here I will get some small bonus as the time passes. Other actions are, for instance, the art. How we have a civilization game, we will need, of course, some wonders. And so now these are all mixed up. Let's say this is the third, in the third era, we will have maybe Louvre, San Pietro, Statue of Liberty, and the Orient Express, even more. And by playing the art card, I pay 1 cube. I spend 1 cube, and I will take 1 of this card. The wonder, they are immediately built and immediately available. Okay, from the next section, they will be available from the player, so the player will stack up here all the wonders that have built during the game. And the wonder, they can be used during one turn, once in a turn. And if you activate, for instance, the Tour Eiffel, it will allow you to recover 2 cubes.
Okay.
And so these are more or less the effects. There are several of them. No need to enter too much in details. Another thing that the wonders are useful is that with the tourism action, they will give you victory point at the end of the, usually at the end of the game, because the tourism will be available only starting from the Industrial Revolution and advanced version from the internet.
Got it.
And so you will score some points according to how many of them you have. Then, okay, we have this action that will allow you to recover cube. Basically, you...
Which you'll need to have more actions later.
Yeah, because that you will need them for spending. We have trade for trading with others. The trade, it's automatic. There are no discussion or no anything else. If the, let's say that the yellow player is more advanced on the technology level, the red player, if they are adjacent to each other, may steal one technology, and the yellow player will gain some victory points and will have some compensation. And of course, we have the map. We also need some way to expand our civilization.
So that's how we explore.
And so we, by exploring, we spend our cubes to put them on the map.
Okay.
And the more territory you have, probably the more points you may score at the end of the round. And then we have two actions for the war, for carrying out aggression and war. The first one, which is the raid action, it's just a way to recover some cube for the attacking and making some victory point. The loser will not lose anything. So it's completely transparent. So it's, I'm getting raid, okay, it's just, you attacked me, but you're not doing any damage, actually, any actual damage to the other civilization. While some damage you can do with the war action. In the war action, basically, you remove, if you are stronger, you remove the cube of the enemy. But the cube is not the power cube is not destroyed. It it can be, it goes back into the in the user pool and it can be used later. So some situation could also be used for the fight too many territories. And finally, we have the revolution. When one player uses the revolution card, the turn it's over. And so we score and we manage all the details at the end of the turn.
That was going to be my one question was, how does the turn end? And there we go.
Yeah. One thing interesting about the game is that as the players perform actions, we're saying, the player, let's say, starts with the technology action, then maybe they will play military action, art, and so on and so forth. But this card, they're kept in a queue. So, and once, if they are in the queue, they are, of course, they are not in my hand, and I will not play them. I cannot play them. So the way is that I call the turn end, and this allow me to recover the revolution one card at my choice. And then everybody during the end of the turn will recover also two actions. But the actions that stay in the queue...
So you
they
might not get all of them back all at once.
Exactly.
Well, I know we've got a few other cards here, which unfortunately,
we have,
well, in the interest of time, just give us their names.
We have civilization, so we had advisors of each civilization. So, for instance, this one are for the Chinese civilization. We have Confucius, Bruce Lee, and that's and so on. And these are basically one-shot action. They're slightly stronger. You play once, they are discarded, put back in the game, and you don't use them anymore. And you acquire them as you develop your technology. Also, as you develop your technology also, you may play two actions or three actions all together.
Okay.
So you the play the game at the end of the day, it will be much more faster.
Okay.
Then each action probably will take a little bit longer, but that's not. And then we have also the leader. Again, wonders, leader, advisor, they're all ingredients in civilization game. Leaders in Historia, they are, each player will take one leader for each era, and they will give you some target. Basically, for instance, this one is Pericles. If you, by the end of the first era, if you have 6 military points, so at least here on the level, you can score 3 points. If you have at least 4 wonders, you will score 6 points.
All right.
And, okay, basically that's it.
Well, you know, I think that gives us a really good idea. I just have one question before we wrap up, which is, if you were playing this as a solo game, what's your goal? How are you going to win for a solo game?
Okay, for a solo game, the goal is survive.
Okay.
And, okay, if you survive, it's to score more points than the bots, because you are playing with the bots. Each bot, you can set a different level of, difficulty, and so it's it may be hard to win the game, to survive and win the game.
Well, Marco, I know that's a lot to try and clear the small amount of time, but I think that gives me a good idea of what to expect if we go out and check out Historia.
Thank you.
That's perfect. See, it wasn't so hard.